So let's look at an example of how a write-back cache would work. Say we have a small four-entry cache that is direct map. Each line has a valid bit, a tag, and a dirty bit. We don't need the LRU counter because in a direct map cache, we know exactly what to replace. We don't need the LRU counters to tell us that. Let's say that the processor is doing this sequence of accesses and A, B, and C map to different sets in the cache. The first access is write A, so what we do is we have a miss. All of our valid bits are zero, so it doesn't matter what the rest of the cache has because none of the lines are valid. When we have the first write to A, we will bring A here, we will change the valid bit to 1, and we will change the tag to correspond to A. Because this is a write, the processor, as soon as the data is brought in, will write it and the dirty bit will be set to 1. Next, we have a read to A. The processor checks the tag and the valid bit, sees that the tag matches A and the valid bit is 1, so it can just use A. The fact that the dirty bit is 1 doesn't change anything. Next, let's say we have a read B. We don't find anything that matches B in the cache, or maybe if this does, the valid bit is 0, so it doesn't matter. So we will have a miss and bring B into the cache, change the tag to correspond to B, change the valid bit to 1 to indicate that we do have something here now. And because this is only a read, the dirty bit will be 0. Next, let's say we read C. It's a miss. Bring C in. Change the tag and the valid bit. It's a read. So the dirty bit starts out at 0. Next, what we have is a write to C. We check if it's a hit, and it is. We write only to the cache and change the dirty bit to 1. And now, as you can see, the dirty bit for every line indicates simply, was the line ever written since it was last brought into the cache? Let's continue this by an access to E that is a read, and let's say that E maps where A is. So now what needs to happen is we're gonna check here to see whether the tag matches E. It doesn't, so we have a miss. Our replacement policy is simple for direct map caches. We simply replace whatever is there. So at this point, we cannot just bring in E from memory. First, we have to take the data for A that we have written and not written to memory yet. Because the dirty bit is 1, this block gets sent to memory as a write. After that happens, we can bring E in, set the tag and valid bit and the dirty bit to 0 because it's a read, and this continues on. Let's say that now we have a read to F, which replaces B. When we want to replace B, we check the dirty bit. It's 0, so B doesn't get sent to memory. It simply gets overwritten with the data from F we fetch. And because this is a read, we get a 0 here, and so on.